person I have become is because of him. And he is the executive director of International Medical Campus. So that is the reason I am here today explaining things to you. This is exactly me before, one day before I left to Belarus, right? This is the first day when I was actually doing bioorganic chemistry. This is basically my second home. Second home in Belarus, the library, for the first 2 years. We used to spend a lot of time there in the whole anatomy and histology. So these are just random photographs that I've just compiled to show you all the exposure that I got. Another very big advantage, I think Intika will explain, that we study in a group setting. I think Mr. Amila must have discussed it, where we have a group of 10 to 12, maximum 14 in a group. So, you know, the teachers know you personally, they know you personally, they know your potential and they help you out in that way. So these are just various photographs. This is polygenic therapy. So, you know, we have different rotations. So this is another teacher who taught us polygenic therapy. This is another cycle. We had immunology now. I think Dr. Inoka as well as Dr. Mandula, he actually explained that we do not, in Sri Lanka, we do not have, intensives. So these are fields that are not there, but we did rotations on these different things. So that is why, you know, this exposure in an MD program is quite good. Even though that one year you actually spend extra, I feel it is worthwhile. Again, this is just me. These are in the hospital setting, so you know we are freely allowed to actually go around in the operation theater. You know, we get to assist on different things, but it all depends on how much of interest you show towards the professor or the lecturer or the doctor who's teaching you. Because if you want to, I would say there are people who might have left from my university.